Now, here in Seoul, U.S. Ambassador to South Korea Sung Kim has urged Japan to acknowledge a sexual enslavement of women in the early 20th century, calling it a grave human rights violation. Ambassador Kim has also asked Tokyo to refrain from any more of what he called provocative actions. Our Hwang Seong-hee has the details.
U.S. Ambassador to South Korea Sung Kim says he understands why South Korean Foreign Minister Yoon Byung-se took the so-called comfort women issue to the United Nations.
The comfort women issue, the sex slaves issue, is a grave human rights violation. We understand the pain that's felt by these surviving women from that awful experience.
Ambassador Kim urged the Japanese government to work towards reducing the pain and suffering of those forced into sexual slavery by its military in the early 20th century. He said the statement issued by the U.S. Embassy in Japan following Japanese Prime Minister Shinzo Abe's visit to the controversial Yasukuni War Shrine late last year was a hard-hitting warning. The shrine honors 14 Class A war criminals. So visits by high-ranking Japanese officials anger Japan's neighboring countries.
And I think, as we've made clear, very clear, we would like Japan to address concerns of its neighbors, and that includes refraining from actions that are seen as provocative.
Ambassador Kim called on the two neighbors to work together on mending ties, as trilateral cooperation between South Korea, the U.S., and Japan is critical for regional security. This view was echoed by Tom Donilon, a former White House National Security Advisor, on Thursday. At a seminar in Washington, Donilon expressed the hope that the leaders of the two countries meet for talks on the sidelines of the upcoming nuclear security summit this month. But as long as Prime Minister Shinzo Abe sticks with his nationalistic stance, summit talks with his South Korean counterpart don't seem likely. President Park Geun-hye has refused to sit down with the Japanese leader since taking office, saying the country must first embrace truth and reconciliation. Hwang Seong-hee, Arirang News.